Jared Poland, FronosPhoto.com, and this is your
long time no see
photo news fix.
All right.
This fix is brought to you by Private Internet Access, the world's leading VPN, or as I like to call them, PIA. PIA is a VPN that hides your IP address, encrypts your connection, and keeps you safe online. With travel starting to ramp up once again, I've downloaded PIA on my laptop, iPad, and iPhone, so no matter where I am in the world, I can browse the internet anonymously with a private IP address and strong encryption. More importantly, if I'm out of the US and want to stream a show that's only available in the US, I simply turn on the VPN and switch to a US-based server, and boom, I'm watching my show as if I was still sitting at home with my cat. Meow. There's nothing worse than being connected to a hotel's Wi-Fi and feeling like someone's watching over my shoulder as I'm browsing late at night. That's why I recommend you check out PIA and take advantage of this special offer for 2 years plus 3 months free for only $2.59 a month with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Head on over to privateinternetaccess.com/JaredPoland to sign up today. First up, Sigma has introduced the 35mm f1.4 DN art lens for Sony E mount cameras. Now, does anyone watching know what the DN stands for? On the count of three, everybody scream it at your screen. One, two, three. Whoa, John. Yeah, I heard you, John. That was rough.
Nothing but foul language and toilet humor.
It actually stands for digital native, AKA it's designed from the ground up and doesn't just slap an adapter on a DSLR lens. I did take this lens out into the real world as well as gave it the two most important tests in all of photography reviewing, the wind tunnel test and the sniff test. And I don't remember if it passed either of them.
Dude, I get that checked out if I were you.
You can check out my full review, the link is down below, but don't do it until the fix is over. Here's my quick take on this new art lens. It's fast, sharp, colorful, and priced really well when it's put up against Sony's new native 1.4 G Master. Now, there was nothing that stood out at me while using this lens that screamed, "Don't buy it!" Which is something I said back in the day at Alan's Camera, Steven, and Alan almost fell over.
Always be closing.
Does it focus as fast as the Sony version? Probably not. Did it hinder my ability to get the shot? No. Now, at the end of the day, the majority of the people watching this will be better off dropping $900 on the Sigma Art lens versus the $500 more for the Sony G Master. Now, in my review, I said I was probably gonna go with the Sony, but recommended that most people go with the Sigma. I mean, for most people, I think you could take that 500 bucks and do something else with it. The reason is simple. If you're shooting for fun or still building out your kit, you're better off putting the savings towards an additional piece of glass. Next up.
Didn't you forget something?
Wait, just kidding. There's one thing I forgot to mention about the Sigma lens. It's also available for the
L-Mount Alliance.
Next up, in a story that I wanted to add last week but totally forgot to do, DxO Mark has released their sensor score for the Z7 II, and people are going to be pissed. And by pissed, I mean nobody's gonna be pissed except for those Nikon haters out there, like Steven.
Hey!
Steven doesn't hate Nikon.
Y'all ready for this?
I said, are you ready for this? Let me say it again, are you ready for this? The DxO score of the Z7 Space 2 is 100! Here's what DxO had to say. Le Nikon Z7 II a urban un skier global der Chapeau DxO Mark de 100. Ce qui est un peu. Whatever. They're French, and I'm doing a really bad job of reading the French.
Les incompetents.
All right, we know that my French sucks. Now, for those who didn't know, DxO is in France.
Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Okay, this is what they said. The Nikon Z7 Space 2 achieved an overall DxO Mark sensor score of 100, which is a slight improvement over the model it replaced and puts it in joint first place in our sensor ranking for the full frame sensors, alongside the likes of the Nikon D850, DSLR, the Panasonic Lumix DCS1R, and the older Sony A7 R3 mirrorless model.
Whoop-de-doo! What does it all mean?
Does this mean that Nikon is saved?
No.
because a DxO score does not translate to more or less sales, in my opinion.
Opinions are like assholes.
Or screw that, it's actually true. It doesn't lead to any more sales.
What are you trying to convince me of exactly?
There's zero doubt in my mind that the Z7 Space 2 captures fantastic images. I've said it time and time again, I love the quality of Nikon's files. But the facts, yes, the facts are that the Z system is behind Canon and Sony as a complete system. Now you can yell at me all you want in the comments, because the more comments I get, either they're good or bad, the more YouTube is happy. And finally, we have two camera rumors, starting with Sony. Sony Alpha Rumors is at it once again. This time around, not one, not two, but
three.
Reliable sources told him the same one rumor, that at the end of May, Sony will announce a new high-end APS-C E-mount camera. Now, like always, there's no actual concrete evidence, just a promise, and we all know what they say about promises.
Everybody's got one.
Cut it out.
Or something like that.
Right here?
This new camera will supposedly replace the A6600, and for as much as I bust the balls of crop sensor cameras, the A6600 is a powerful little camera. But my question is, with the full-frame A7C being the same size as the A6000 series cameras, at what point does it make fiscal sense to retire the APS-C line? Or is it that much less expensive to make the crop sensors that it makes sense to continue to ride the train? And the second rumor comes from the more reputable Canon Rumors, which says a good source, which is a hell of a lot more reputable than anything that Sony Alpha Rumors has to say, has told them some interesting potential specs for the Canon R3. He is claiming that it will have a very high resolution sensor with a resolution trick. Now, does that mean that it will allow you to shoot 30 frames per second at 20 megapixels, but portraits and landscapes at 75 to 80? Now, that would be interesting, though I personally would probably shoot everything at the highest res, because that's just me. They also go on to say it will have quad pixel AF, which is something that I said that it would have that Canon told us that it wouldn't have. We'll see who's right. But we don't know any official concrete specs. These are just rumors. What do you think the R3 will have? And there you have it. That's your photo news fix this time around. To check out the last fix, go ahead and click on the screen right here. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And that's where I'm gonna leave it. Jared Polenfronos, photo.com. See ya.